awakening. Have you felt it?
Whatever happened to predictability? The milkman, the paperboy, evening TV. You miss your old familiar friends, but waiting just around the bend. Everywhere you look, everywhere there's a heart.
My name is Branch Russell Founder, and I go to Lincoln High School in Sioux Falls, South Dakota, and I am fed up with our government. Have you seen the internet lately?
No.
Well, we're ranked number 2 in the nation for being the most corrupt. South Dakota is among most southern states in the hall of shame that is American government. Not only do our legislators pass laws and make us look like hicks to the rest of the country, but the laws checking those very representatives seem to be non-existent.
What do you mean?
I mean, the government can do what they want, but we can't stop them.
Yet.
Got the club going up on a Tuesday. Got your girl in the cut and she chooses.
Hey, Branch here again. Remember what I said earlier?
Turn down for what?
No, I do not.
That's okay. I got all the information for you right here.
According to this fact from stateintegrity.org, people in SD have little regulations imposed upon them concerning lobbyism. This is where people can pay politicians to influence their vote on certain laws. Most states have laws that stop this madness, but sadly, South Dakota is among the few that don't.
That's pretty bad, but it could be worse.
It is worse.
Yeah, you ever heard of a man named Mike Rounds?
Perhaps. I've heard many names, but I'm not expected to remember them all.
Well, what do you think about Mike Rounds?
I think he won the election.
There you go. Why, yes. You see, Mike Rounds, our former governor and out senator-elect, is a menace. He could be possibly facing charges for perjury and embezzlement. In most states, a felony charge on the horizon could deter voters. But not in South Dakota. Rounds won with over 51% of the votes.
I steal money all the time. You don't see me getting elected.
That's because you, possibly like Mike Rounds, are a felon. And you can't vote. What do you think of Mike Rounds?
I know I've committed many transgressions, but if Mike hasn't been indicted, he shouldn't be judged, right? A criminal if you aren't convicted, idiot.
No, you pile of ignorant slop. Anybody who commits a crime is a criminal. You're thinking of a convict.
Oh, my bad. I guess I shouldn't believe everything I read off Grant Winter's Twitter.
You're right. Never believe anything you read off the Twitter page of Grant Winter.
Continues. Cindy Schild is our guest from the American Petroleum Institute, where she's the manager of downstream and industry operations. Thank you for being here.
Thanks for having me this morning.
Wanted to talk about the Keystone XL pipeline on Wednesday. The House took a vote. Here's the headline in The Hill. The House votes to override President Obama on Keystone. Cindy Schild, tell us about the House vote and what it meant.
It's Congress entering the picture, or re-entering the picture. This has been a project that's been proposed nearly 5 years ago. It has to go through a process to get approval. Ultimately, that comes from the State Department and the President. They've been taking a look at the environmental part of this quotient, the equation, for the past, again, 5 years. They have to make a decision if it's in the nation's best interest to build this pipeline.
The Keystone XL, a widely debated oil pipeline that almost found a home running through South Dakota, was favored by the representatives in our state.
But wait, I thought it was a good thing. I thought it created jobs and energy.
What's the matter with Chew? If it destroys the Earth, then there will be no jobs at all.
All right, let's redo this.
Okay, what are we doing?
Wow, I didn't think of it that way.
What is human trafficking?
Is just another example of how South Dakota representatives are influenced by big business and money. If we had more regulations on how businesses can lobby politicians, we would have our representatives representing us rather than big oil companies.
I love talking to you. I learned so much. Okay.
Closing time, open all the doors and let you out into the world. Closing time, turn all of the lights on over every boy and every girl. Closing time, one last call for alcohol, so finish your whiskey or beer. Closing time, you don't have to go home, but you can't stay here.